So, welcome to the class presentation of Standard 1. Hello Q, what are you doing?
Hi Rio, I am watching Dove Studio 1.0.
What is Dove Studio 1.0?
It's a studio where the tiny dots are in our Rachna Higher Secondary School Summer present episodes of folk tales with morals.
Wow, that's really great.
Yes. It also tells us how animals enjoy their lives, found reasons to be happy, and had fun with their buddies.
It's amazing. Can I also watch these episodes with you?
Yes, of course. I'll be delighted to have you on my show. Let's get started.
Hello friends, did you know all the birds are unique? So come with me, let's see them dancing and having fun.
Can you hear the black crow? Coco says the black crow. Can you hear the black crow sitting on the tree? Pigeons, gray or white is the color of the pigeons. Can you see the flock of pigeons eating grains and seeds? Can you spot the owl on the tree? Hoot hoot says the owl on the tree. Can you spot the owl on the tree swirling its head around? Can you spot the duck in the pond? Says the duck in the pond. Can you spot the duck in the pond waddling away and beyond? Can you spot the peacock? Colorful feathers of the peacock. Can you spot the peacock shimmering and rustling away? Can you spot the sparrows? Tiny brown sparrows. Can you spot the sparrows feeding on grains and seeds?
I am a bird.
Tweet, tweet, tweet.
I spread my wings.
Tweet, tweet, tweet.
Rustle my feathers.
Tweet, tweet, tweet.
And start to sing.
Tweet, tweet, tweet. I know. Not all birds can fly.
I have long legs, my feathers pink. I bend my neck to get a drink. Which bird am I now, do you know?
That's right, you've got it, flamingo!
Now, which bird am I? I cannot fly, but I can run, the biggest bird under the sun. Which bird am I, do you know which?
You've got it right, I'm an ostrich!
Now, which bird am I? I love to swim, I live on ice fish, for my dinner is so nice. Which bird am I? Yes, and you'll win.
No, I can't fly, I'm a penguin.
I am a bird.
Tweet, tweet, tweet.
I spread my wings.
Tweet, tweet, tweet.
Birds are unique.
Tweet, tweet, tweet.
He rocks in the treetops all day long, hopping and popping and singing his song. All the little birdies on Jaybird Street love to hear the robin go tweet, tweet, tweet.
Rockin' Robin, tweet, rock, rock, rockin' Robin, tweet. Go rock a robin, cause we're really gonna rock tonight.
Tweet-tweet-tweet-tweet. Every little swallow, every chickadee, every little bird in the tall oak tree.
Tweet-tweet.
He rocks in the treetops all day long, hopping and bopping. hopping and singing his song. All the little birdies on Jaybird Street love to hear the robin go tweet, tweet, tweet.
Rockin' Robin, tweet. Rock, rock, rockin' Robin, tweet. Go rockin' Robin, cause you're really gonna rock tonight. Tweet, twiddle-dee-dee.
Every little swallow, every chicken, the wise old owl, the big black crow, flapping their wings, singing go bird, go.
Rockin' Robin, tweet.
Rockin' Robin,
tweet, twiddle-dee-dee.
Go rockin' Robin, cause you're really gonna rock tonight.
Tweet,
all right.
Once a crow looked at a swan and thought to himself, how beautiful a swan looks. A swan has white feather and I am so black. Saying this, the crow expressed its feeling to the swan.
Swan dear, you are so beautiful. You have white feathers all over your body. And look at me. I am all black, dark black, just like coal.
Me? Beautiful? No, no. According to me, my parrot is most beautiful. It has two colors and I have only one.
Then Crow approaches to Parrot and expresses its view.
Oh dear Parrot, you are so beautiful.
Me? Tick, tick, tick. No dear, I'm not so beautiful. According to me, peacock is the prettiest bird of all, as it has many colors. It is too colorful too. I see no other bird more beautiful than the peacock.
Then the crow goes to the peacock and expresses its thought.
Dear peacock, you are the most beautiful bird on this planet. Everyone admires you and they love to see you dancing. They come from different directions, especially to see you.
My dear crow, you rightly said I have many colors. But you are the luckiest bird in this planet. As because of your color, you have never been trapped. Because of our beauty and these pretty colors in our feathers, we have been trapped in this cage. My dear crow, you are so lucky to be free. You are the luckiest bird of all.
The crow started thinking how foolish she was and thanked God for creating him the way he looked and his appearance.
The moral of the story is, do not compare yourself to others. One should be happy and satisfied with what one has in life. Thank you.
That we should not compare ourselves with others.
for the next episode. Long, long ago, the elephants had a very short nose that looked a lot like a nose of a pin. It was not as long as it is now, but an elephant's baby changed it forever. Let's see how. There was a baby elephant called Eddie. He too had no trunk but only a short nose. He could wiggle it from side to side but could not pick up things with it. Eddie was full of questions. One day he went to his tall uncle the giraffe and asked him a question.
Adende kum, adende kum, adende hey!
Giraffe.
The tallest mammal on the land.
I'm a groovy giraffe.
Mr. Giraffe, why do you have spots all over your body?
Oh, Eddie, go on your way.
Then he went to his little friend Rabbit and asked him a question.
Bounce and bounce and bounce like a bunny. Hop and flop and flop like a bunny.
One day he came across a butterfly and asked her the same question.
Fly, fly, fly the butterfly in the meadow is flying high.
Hi beautiful butterfly, can you tell me what does the crocodile eat for dinner?
You ask too many questions. Go to the river and find out for yourself.
Eddie started his journey to the river. He had never seen a crocodile before. After a long and very tiring journey, he finally reached the river. He was walking along the edge of the river when he suddenly tripped over something that looked like a log of wood.
But the log turned out to be the crocodile himself. He opened an eye and winked at the little elephant.
Excuse me, have you seen a crocodile?
Look in the river and you'll find me. I'm Mr. Crocodile, yes, that's me.
Hi, little one. I am the crocodile.
I'm so glad to meet you. Will you please tell me what do you have for dinner?
Come here, little one, and I'll whisper in your ear.
As soon as the little elephant put his head close to the crocodile's mouth, the crocodile caught him by his black short nose. And so the struggle began. The crocodile sat down and pulled till his nose began to stretch.
Seeing this, the crocodile began tugging harder. Eddie's nose stretched and stretched
It was soon 5 feet long. Finally, the crocodile gave up and swiftly went into the water. And he was safe from the crocodile.
Suddenly, he noticed that his nose was too long. He waited for his nose to shrink. However, it never shrunk. Then he understood that his nose was very useful. He went to his home. He explained other elephants too.
My new trunk might look strange, but please do not be fooled. I need a big bunch of grass without bending down. I can scoop up some cool mud and drop it on my head. So from picking food to keeping cool, my trunk is very useful.
Soon, all the elephants understood that the trunk was very useful. One by one, they went to the river to get a new nose from the crocodile.
The moral of the story is, curiosity can rediscover new potentials.
We should learn to make the most of what we have.
All the elephants were happy with their new noses, and they decided to celebrate their journey by dancing.
Well, I have two big ears and a long, long nose and a big, big belly and stinky toes, a little tail, two round eyes. I'm a big elephant. Let's dance, guys. Oh, stomp, 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 wiggle, 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 stomp, 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 wiggle, 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 stomp, 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 wiggle, 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 doing the elephant dance. Stomp, 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 wiggle, 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 stomp, 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 wiggle, 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 stomp, 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 wiggle, 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 doing the elephant dance. Walk, 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 stop! Run, 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 stop! Stomp, 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 stop! Wiggle, 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 stop! Well, I have two big ears and a long, long nose and a big, big belly and stinky toes, a little tail, two round eyes. I'm a big elephant. Let's dance, guys!
New abilities. I am eager to know more now.
Hello everyone, welcome to the virtual class presentation of Grade 1C. We are super excited to present the famous folktale, The Ant and the Grasshopper.
Do you do your homework? I am about to complete it. You need to finish your work before you play. Why, Grandma? You will get to know once you watch this story.
There was a happy grasshopper who likes to play, sing and dance all day while the ants were busy working.
In the summer the ants were a-working, bringing food to their hill every day. Grasshopper sang in the sunshine, on his fiddle his song he did play. Fi-dee-di-dee-da-doo-da-dee-da-do, fi-dee-do-dee-da-dee-dee-da-day. I will sing all the while, neath the sunshine, neath the moon I will dance, I will play. In the summer the ants were a-working, bringing food sunshine. On his fiddle his song he did play. Fi-dee-di-di-da-doo-da-dee-da-do. Fi-dee-do-dee-da-dee-dee-da-day. I will sing all the while neath the sunshine. Neath the moon I will dance, I will play. Fi-dee-di-di-da-doo-da-dee-da-do. Fi-dee-do-dee-da-dee-dee-da-day. I will sing all the while neath the sunshine. Neath the moon I will dance, I will play.
Don't you ever work?
Who, me? Of course not.
Don't you ever get tired of playing?
Who, me? Of course not. Do you want to play with me?
No, I am very busy right now.
Come on, let's sing together.
No, I have lots of work to do.
Work, work, work. That's all you do? You don't have time to play or sing with me?
No, I don't.
But why are you in such a hurry?
A kernel of corn to my home.
What for?
I have to store food for the winter.
How can you think about winter on such a fine day?
Because the winter will be here soon and the food will be too hard to find. You should do the same.
I don't want to worry about the winter right now. You just go ahead and work, work, work. I will just play, sing and dance.
Do you have enough food to eat?
I have plenty of food right now.
And what about tomorrow?
I don't worry about tomorrow.
What I do, goodbye.
So the ants wait on its wheel and continue its work. Soon the weather turned cold. All the food lying in the field was covered with thick white blankets of snow.
I should have listened to the ant. It's so cold that I can't even play or sing songs anymore. I don't have food to eat. I am sure the ants will help me.
Grasshopper went to the ants' hill.
Please give me something to eat. I am cold. I am hungry. I have learned my lesson. From now, I will work in summer.
All right. You may come in and have steaming hot corn soup.
So, what did you learn from this story, Kian? I learned that I need to work hard before playing.
Yes, indeed. We need to finish our work before playing. And by doing this, we'll reap the benefits of tomorrow. Thank you.
elephant and his friends are going to show some more interesting things. Let's go.
And here comes the story of a great elephant. One day, an elephant wandered into a jungle. In search of friends, he saw a monkey on a tree. The elephant said,
"Will you be my friend?
You are too big. You can't swing from trees like me."
Next day, he met the rabbit.
"Will you be my friend?
You are too big. You can't play in my burrow."
Then he went to a frog.
"Please make friendship with me."
"How is this possible? You're too big. You can't leap about like me."
Elephant was upset. A fox appeared.
"Will you be happy to have a friend like me?"
"Sorry, sir, you are too big."
The next day, the elephant saw all the animals were running for their lives. Elephant asked the fox,
"What is the matter?"
"There is a lion and he is trying to kill all of us. All the animals were running away to hide."
Meanwhile, lion kept eating up whatever he could find. The elephant went to the lion and said,
"Please, Mr. Lion, don't eat up all these poor animals."
"Mind your own business."
The elephant had no choice but to give the lion a hefty kick. The frightened lion ran for his life. The elephant ambled back into the jungle and announced the good news to all. All the animals thanked him and said, "You are just the right size to be our friend."
A friend in need?
everyone. It's my pleasure to present you all an interesting folktale that happened in a dense forest. It's about how the hippo gets a tiny tail. This is a beautiful presentation presented by my classmates of 1A. Let's grab our seats and watch the magic unfold. Thank you.
A long time ago, a Brahmin was traveling through a dense forest.
Oh, I've been walking since morning. I am tired now. I need a place to rest for the night. But this is a dense forest with wild animals. What a strange jungle. Here, the animals have no tails.
As he was walking, he read the lion's den. Seeing the Brahmin, the lion pounded upon him to make him his supper.
Oh, the king of the jungle, if you spare my life, I will offer a nice gift to all the animals. I have a magic bag with a variety of tails. The tails would help the animals to ward off insects away. But with the condition that before noon, all the animals should come and get their tails.
Oh, that's wonderful. I will accept your offer. Oh, wise owl, spread this news across the jungle. Let all the animals be here on time to get their gift.
At dawn, the king of the jungle was first to go to grab his tail. The Brahmin had a huge magic bag with heaps of tails for the animals to choose from. He put his hand in and took out a long, marvelous golden tail with black tassels at the end. He puts it on and roars with pride.
Hearing the news, all the other animals rush to get their gift.
Oh, let them all rush. I'll eat, sleep, and then go and get my tail.
Meanwhile, the fox got a long, thick, bushy tail. Like a brush, he put it on and went away proudly. Squirrel, too, got a huge bushy tail, which curved up over his back before leaping away. The horse came next, and from the bag the Brahmin pulled was a long, strong black tail. The horse combed out until it was silky and straight. The horse felt delighted and galloped away. The cat received a straight tail which wagged from side to side or up and down as she pleased. The monkey was given an extremely long tail. He curled it over his arm so that he would not trip over it. The elephant got a tail which looked like a chewed string, but he put it on quite happily and lumbered off. The mouse got a long tail. He put it on and scuttled away. Last but not the least was the rabbit. Its tail was tiny, but white, soft, round, fluffy. One by one, all the animals received a tail each. It was late afternoon by the time Hippo reached. There were insects all around him.
I better get my tail. Oh, Brahmin, can I also get my tail?
Too late, but let me check in my magic bag.
lucky. I have found one tiny thin tail for you that no other animal would have wanted it, but it's all yours.
But the hippo was incredibly happy to get one. He was excited to show off his tail to other animals in the jungle. He happily sang and danced along the way.
All the other animals gathered
at the lion's den to show the new gift to each other. They're extremely happy to have a tail to chase away insects. They all decided to celebrate their joy by singing and dancing.
Tiger's tails.
Long tail, long tail, long tail, loose tails.
Mouses and monkeys' tails.
Short tail, short tail, short tail, loose tails.
Rabbits and bears' tails.
Of class 1G.
Ugly duckling.
It's a beautiful day. Mother duck takes all her 7 ducklings to the farmyard near the river.
She has 6 yellow ducklings, but the 7th one is gray and big.
Quack, quack, this place is so pretty.
Quack, quack, I love this place too.
Children, why don't you introduce yourself?
Yes, Mom is yours.
A deer, a female deer, gray, a jungle golden sun.
Ha ha ha, you look so funny.
This is the ugliest duck I've ever seen. Please go away from here.
Nobody loves me. Nobody wants me. Nobody wants to be friends with me.
At last, one day, the ugly duckling decides to run away. He comes by a river and starts crying. When a wise frog asks him,
"Why are you crying?"
"Everybody hates me because I'm ugly."
"Why do you think you're ugly? Beauty is inside you and not in your physical appearance."
"But nobody thinks like that. Everybody hates me because I'm ugly."
"Little duck, look at the positive side of yours. You must have a special ability that differentiates you from the rest."
"Well, I swim very fast, faster than my siblings."
"Well then, you must practice so that you can improve and feel proud of yourself. You could even participate in the Animal Olympics."
"Really?"
"Of course, dear. My friend will give you proper training for the Olympics."
"Thank you, Mr. Frog, for making me understand that I should believe in myself."
After a few months, Mother Duck and her children got the news about Animal Olympics, where the ugly duckling was participating.
"Mother, we have realized that we should not have sent him away, as he is a part of our family."
"Yes, I agree with my brother. We should be with him too. And we should apologize for the wrongdoings to his team."
It was Animal Olympics Day, and everyone was very excited to be the part of the competition.
All the racers were preparing themselves and the ugly duckling too until.
"My dear son, we are all happy to see you."
"Even I am delighted to see you all."
"We are so happy for an healthy best for your race.
Believe in yourself and you'll do wonders." "Thank you so much for your love and support. I'll surely try my best."
Moral of the story is, believe in yourself.
You are braver than you think.
More talented than you know.
And more capable than you imagine.
Thank you.
Today we all have learned a very important lesson which makes our lives better. Believe in yourself
We are more braver than we think, more talented than we know, and more capable than we can imagine.
Yes, indeed, Rio. Don't forget the important lessons we have learned today and for all those who are watching us right now.
Hope you've enjoyed our NAV Studio 1.0 episodes. See you soon!